रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। माय नेम इज़ नाजिया ज़हीर। आई एम पोस्टेड एज लेक्चरर एट गवर्नमेंट नज़द गर्ल्स डिग्री कॉलेज। माय टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ द अर्थ एज ए स्फीयर। इन टू दिस टॉपिक आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज़ द ज्योमेट्री ऑफ अ स्फीयर एंड व्हाट इज़ द मूवमेंट ऑफ द स्फीयर। द अर्थ इज़ रफली राउंड इन शेप, but it is not perfectly round as represented by the globes used in schools. It is slightly flattened at the north pole and south pole and bulges out slightly at the equator, just like an orange shape. We call this an earth globe or geoid shape. The diameter of the earth at the equator is 12,746 kilometers. Its diameter from the north pole to the south pole, it is slightly less, which is 12,704.5 kilometer, due to the flattening of the north and the south pole. The Earth's circumference at the equator is 40,232.5 kilometer. Once the Earth was assumed to be spherical, it was logic to divide it by means of circles. Mathematicians had decided that the circle should be divided into 360 parts by means of 360 straight lines. Radiating from the center of the circle, the angles between each of these lines was called a degree. For such a large circle as the Earth's circumference, further subdivisions became necessary. Each degree was divided into 60 minutes, and each minute was further subdivided into 60 seconds. Using this knowledge, it was possible to imagine a series of lines on the Earth's surface. In actuality, circles around the spherical Earth, some running north to south and some are running east to west, of these grid are still called parallels. The name the Greek gave them, the north-south lines, are called meridians. Parallels never intersect one another, whereas meridians intersect at the top and at the bottom of the sphere. Latitude and longitude. The lines which run in east to west direction are called latitude, and the lines which cut across them in a north-south direction are referred as longitude. Although these lines are shown on globes, we must remember that they are only imaginary lines, not real, and don't appear in fact on the earth. The equator itself is a line of latitude. It shows by this red one line. It is a large imaginary circle drawn around the middle of the earth, exactly midway between the north and south poles. The other lines of latitude are circles drawn parallel to the equator. They are also called parallels of latitude. These circles become smaller and smaller with distance from the equator, so that at the poles they are only mere points. Lines of latitude are numbered from 0 degree, the equator, to 90 degree, the north, and to the south poles. There are some facts about the lines of latitude. They are known as parallels. They run in east-west direction. They measure distance north or south from the equator. They are parallel to one another and never meet. They cross the prime meridian at right angles. They lie in planes that cross the Earth's axis at right angles. They get shorter towards the poles with only the equator, the longest, a great circle. Degrees are used to measure the sizes of angles, and the degrees of latitude and longitude therefore represent angular distances. For instance, 90 degree north latitude means that the angle formed by two lines, one starting at the north pole and the other starting from the equator, which meet at the center of the earth, is a right angle or 90 degree. Similarly, 23.5 degree north latitude means that the angle formed at the recent of the earth by two lines drawn from the Tropic of Cancer and the equator is 23.5 degree. Beside the equator or 0 degree latitude, neither north or south, middle one. There are four parallels or latitude which should be noted. Two of them are the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. Both are 23.5 degree north and south of the equator. These two parallels mark the limits of the apparent movement of the overhead sun. The other two important parallels are Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle, which are 66.5 degree north and south respectively. Now, the Great Circle. A Great Circle is an imaginary line drawn around the earth, which divides the earth into two equal halves. One is Northern Hemisphere and second is Southern Hemisphere. Hemi means half. The equator is a Great Circle as it divides the earth into two horizontally halves. Every parallel of latitude other than the equator is a small circle because its plane does not pass through the center of the earth, but all the longitudes are equal and great circles. Now, longitude. Lines of longitude are usually called meridians. Meridians are imaginary lines drawn from to the north pole to the south pole. And totally they are 360 number as well as 360 degrees according the division of a circle. One special meridian has been chosen to be the starting point for numbering the meridian. This is 0 degree meridian or prime meridian, which passes through Greenwich in London. All other meridians are numbered either east or west from Greenwich. As there are 360 lines of longitude, there are 180 degrees of longitude east of Greenwich and 180 degree west of it. Just as a degree of latitude can be divided into minutes and seconds, so can a degree of longitude be divided into 60 minutes and 60 seconds. The international deadline or IDL. As the international deadline where the date changes by a day when the line is crossed. The international deadline does not exactly follow the 180 degree longitude. Part of it follows a zigzag course to avoid cutting through land areas. In the north, it takes an easterly bend to avoid the northeastern part of Russia and then series westerwards to allow the Aleutian Islands to be included with Alaska. Now, there are some facts about the lines of longitude. They are known as meridians. They run in a north-south direction. They measure distance east or west, the prime meridian, are farthest apart at the equator and meet at the poles. Cross the equator at right angles. They lie in planes that pass through the earth's axis. They are equal in length and they are halves of great circles. Now, the second topic is movements of the sphere. The earth makes two kinds of movements which take place at the same time. These two movements are most important for student of geography to know. These two movements are responsible for different kinds of phenomena. Let us look into them in further details. They are rotation and revolution. When Earth spins or rotates around its axis, that moves of spinning is called rotation of Earth. And when Earth spins or revolves around the Sun, that movement is called revolution of Earth. This is the movement of rotation and Earth takes place this revolution, this revolve or this orbit, complete its orbit. So, this is called the revolution and this is axis, it is also an imaginary line which moves from north to the south pole. Now, rotation of the earth. As the earth rotates on its axis, which occurs in west to east direction, this motion creates the alternation of day and night, as one half of the planet is always turned towards the sun while the other half always faces away. One complete rotation takes roughly 24 hours, but exactly 23 hours 56 minutes, or one calendar day. During one full revolution around the sun, the earth makes 365.25 rotations. Consider this is the earth's circumference. At the equator is slightly less than 40,000 kilometers. Thus, the place on or near the equator rotates at a speed of 1,666 kilometers per hour continuously, but the distance traveled during a complete rotation diminishes northwest and southward from the equator until it becomes zero at the poles. A person standing on the north or south pole would merely make one full turn in place every 24 hours. This contrast between the force of rotation or at near the poles on one hand and or at near the equator on the other causes the earth to develop that slight bulges at the equator. Now, revolution of the earth. Revolution is the second type of motion of the earth. It takes the movement of the earth around the sun in a fixed path or orbit. Revolution causes the change of season. It takes 365 days and 6 hours, means 1 year, to revolve around the sun. It is important to note that we consider a year as consisting of 365 days only and ignore 6 hours for the sake of convenience. There are some phenomena about which are occurred by the revolution of the earth. First is leap year. 6 hours saved every year are likely to make 1 day, means 24 hours over a span of 4 years. We add this surplus day to the month of February. Every fourth year, February is 29 days instead of 28 days. This year with 366 days, and it is called a leap year. Summer solstice. The earth goes around the sun in an elliptical orbit. The nights are longer than the days of the winter season. This position of the earth is called the summer solstice. Winter solstice. This is on 22nd December. The Tropic of Capricorn gets direct rays of the sun as the south pole tilts towards it. It is summer in southern hemisphere and winter into the northern hemisphere. This is called winter solstice. Equinoxes. Equi means equal, means ke day and night, both are equals. In equinox on 21st March and 23rd September, direct rays of the sun fall directly on the equator. During this period, the whole earth experiences equal day and equal nights. This is called an equinox. Seasons. In places near the equator, there is a little difference between the temperature at different times of the year. This is because the sun shines always overhead or almost so throughout the year. These regions, therefore, don't really have the four seasons, spring, summer, autumn, and winter, which places away from the equator may be named according to the rainfall, the wet or rainy season, and the dry season, or they may also be named according to the prevailing winds, the northeast monsoon season and the southwest monsoon season. Now, here is a documentary which you easily understand about the
seasons.
What causes Earth's seasons? Earth's seasons are caused by Earth's tilt on its axis. Instead of going straight up and down, Earth's axis tilts 23.5 degrees. Can you see why the tilt causes Earth to have seasons throughout the year? Let's find out. Here's the energy of the sun. Notice that it hits the lower half of Earth, called the southern hemisphere, most directly. The sun's energy hits the northern hemisphere too, but look at how the northern hemisphere is pointed away from the sun. Also, the light hits at an angle that causes the energy to be spread out over a greater area. So at this spot in Earth's revolution, it receives less of the sun's energy. When more of the sun's energy hits the southern hemisphere, it causes the temperature to go up. It's summertime. More sunlight, longer days. With less of the sun's energy hitting the northern hemisphere, it gets a lot colder. Put on your winter coat. Less sunlight, shorter days. Let's see how the seasons change as Earth revolves around the sun. So, why do seasons change? Because the tilt of Earth's axis causes the hemispheres to receive different amounts of the sun's energy. That's some cool science.
Thank you very much for watching my video lecture. Feedback and comments will be highly appreciated. Stay home, save life.